Hello everyone, it's Annie, and today I have an impromptu thrifting session that I'm going to do. I'm going out thrifting with my friends, so I'm going to take you with me and let's hope we can find some good books. Let's go. Hello everyone, I am back and I got 5 books. 4 hardcover, 1 is an ARC, which I am a little bit sad about because I know you're not supposed to sell ARCs, but I was really interested in this book, so I got it. I don't know whether I was supposed to tell them at the store, like, hey, you're not actually supposed to sell ARCs. I don't know. Let me know what you guys do when you find an ARC in a thrift store. But anyway, we'll get to that book later. First, we have Beautiful Country. It's actually a book of the month book. So it's beautiful hardcover, really nice condition because it only came out in September. So I don't know who got this book so recently and then donated it to the thrift store, but this is a memoir. And I actually got it for both me and my mom to read. Ooh, I got a book of the month bookmark too. Okay, cool. So this is a memoir about 7-year-old Chen, I think is how you pronounce her first name, arrives in New York City in 1994 full of curiosity, and she is overwhelmed by crushing fear and scarcity. In China, her parents were professors. In America, her family is illegal, and it will require all the determination and small joys they can muster to survive. So I've been really, really interested in this memoir for a while, ever since I saw and heard that it was going to come out. So I'm really hoping that this one is good. And then I got something that I am so excited about, you have no idea. I got In the Quick by Kate Hope Day. I am so excited. When I saw this, I almost like couldn't believe it. I had to do a double take. I was so excited. The only thing is the spine is a little bit damaged, but it was $4, so. But it's just such a shame because the spine is like the prettiest part. It's so pretty, but it's okay. It's okay. I'm so happy to find this book. I have a review of this book out, so absolutely check out that video if you're interested in this. This is a sci-fi book about a girl named June whose uncle had worked on the engines to a spaceship that has since gone missing. And June is like this genius child, and she goes to the astronaut school or whatever you call it, and she becomes an astronaut and goes to this pink planet, hence the pink cover, and she tries to find these people who went missing. And it is such a good book. I know it's kind of not controversial, but it doesn't have a very good rating on Goodreads, let's just say that. But I really enjoyed it. I don't know why other people don't. It was really, really good. And I think it's a really good book, especially if you're looking for more women in sci-fi, which I always am. So I am so glad to have found this. And then I couldn't pass this beautiful hardcover edition of Beartown up. It was only $4 and it's in absolutely perfect condition. Like absolutely nothing wrong with it at all. It is on my to-read list, of course. Beartown is so, so popular, especially on BookTube. And it is becoming winter very soon, so I'm hoping to maybe read it. I am just a little bit scared of this because of the subject matter. I believe it involves sexual assault. So it's not really something I enjoy reading about. So I am just gonna hold this for a rainy day and see whether I'll wanna read it or not. Okay, now this is the arc I was talking about, the Atmospherians. And can I just say that this cover is so creative and gorgeous and I love it. And also I thought that this Alex McElroy was from the McElroy brothers, but he's not. I don't really know much about this. I know that the cover is cool and I know that Noelle from Noelle 7 Pages gave this 5 stars. But that's all I know. I know it's like supposed to be satire and it's supposed to involve cults. And I like reading books about cults and yeah, that's really it. I have not even read the back and I don't plan to. I know that this also doesn't have the greatest rating on Goodreads for some reason. So if you know something that I don't, please let me know. But either way, you know, I figured I'd save this from gathering dust on a thrift store shelf and I'm gonna read it eventually. Okay, last book I am so excited about. This beautiful, pretty much new condition, The Girls I've Been by Tess Sharp. I am so excited about this. This is a sapphic thriller, I believe, or like mystery. It's about this girl. Let me check. I do know what this one's about. It is about Nora O'Malley. As the daughter of a con artist who targets criminal men, she grew up as her mother's protege. But when her mom fell for the mark instead of conning him, Nora pulled the ultimate con, escape. For 5 years, Nora's been playing at normal, but she needs to dust off the skills she ditched because she has three problems. Interesting. Okay, I'm not gonna... It seems like it's a lot of drama. The synopsis is really long, but basically all you have to know is it's gotten great reviews, and look at this cover. It's so cool, and I'm really interested in this. I'm probably gonna read it for one of my future sapphic reading vlogs, so look out for that. All right, and that is it. Thank you so much for watching this thrifting book shopping vlog. I had so much fun thrifting today. I'm so glad that I got so many books and it was so cheap. All of these books were like $4 or $5. So I'm so glad to have found so many beautiful hardcover books for that cheap. I was really, really lucky today. And again, thank you for watching. If you enjoyed, please like and subscribe to my channel and I'll see you next time. Bye. Thank you.